On court, Naomi Osaka appeared as calm and focused as ever. No sign of her inner struggles. But this was to be the world number two's final match at the French Open on Sunday before her shock withdrawal, citing anxiety and depression. Rallying behind the four-time Grand Slam champion, her sponsors and fellow athletes.
I feel for Naomi. I feel like I wish I could give her a hug because I know what it's like. Like I said, I've been in those positions, and that's the only thing I can say. I think she's doing the best that she can.
Today, too, the four Grand Slams releasing a statement in support of Osaka, adding that mental health is a very challenging issue which deserves our utmost attention. We will continue to improve the player experience at our tournaments, including as it relates to media. A significant about turn from earlier this week, when the French Open fined Osaka and threatened to expel her for no longer attending press conferences.
What's happening is you're thrusting a mic underneath, you know, their faces to sort of comment when they haven't really made sense of their emotions and their thoughts as yet. And some individuals who do suffer with social anxiety, that's really very intrusive in those moments.
But it's not the first time the tournament has come in for criticism over its treatment of players. This bodysuit worn by Serena Williams in 2018 was deemed unacceptable, despite its design to protect her from life-threatening blood clots after childbirth. This time around, Osaka's finding that many of her on-court rivals are now on her team, as her strength in speaking out serves up a new spin on an ongoing conversation over mental health. Helena Humphrey, 5 News.